Ed Roy has got this thing called iDetect. And when I first saw that, I said, iDetect what? You know, like you're going down the road on a family vacation with my little eye, I spy. So iDetect is a method for doing lie detection that does not involve that strap around the waist and the squiggly lines.
That's exactly right. You know, polygraph was invented back in the 1927, actually. And it went along really well for about 50 years. Then in 1991, some guys in Utah, in fact, the same fellas that have developed iDetect, computerized the polygraph. So since 1991, there hasn't been any advance until now. These guys were out on a hiking trip, going mountain climbing, actually, and they're theoretical psychologist over at the University of Utah. And they theorized that you could tell if someone was lying by monitoring what the pupils of their eyes were doing. And it turns out their research was true. It was accurate because the brain is in gear much more cognitive effort to tell a lie because you're constructing a story versus telling the truth where you're just recalling an event. So they theorized that this would work. It did work. And 12 years ago, they started working on this process. Now it's developed into a product called iDetect, and it's as accurate as a polygraph now. But when you use it in concert with a polygraph, the accuracy rate goes up to about 97% confidence.
Wow.
Wow, that's pretty strong.
And
it is.
Either one is like 85%, I think.
That's right.
Like that.
That's right.
But together, 97%.
Yep.
Holy cow.
Yep.
So is this being used at present by law enforcement?
Well, let me tell you guys are some of the first in the country to even hear about this.
Woo!
Wow.
This is brand new stuff. As a matter of fact, it was premiered in the United States back in December. Actually, the first police organization to use this is the Utah Salt Lake City Department, Police Department. They vet people that are applying for jobs or getting promotions or transfers. And this was shown for the first time in Washington, D.C. We were up there in December and showed it to the intelligence community and to the national, federal law enforcement folks, and they went gaga.
Hillary Clinton was wearing sunglasses.
Hillary was nowhere around. She was nowhere around. But, you know, it's amazing how with this technology, some of the major problems that we're facing counterintelligence-wise or counterterrorism-wise could be solved. And that's why there's such excitement about this in D.C. now, is because the State Department realizes that we could sit down 10,000, mind you, 10,000 Syrian refugees, give them a 30-minute true-false test while they sit in front of the computer and we monitor their eyes. And within 30 minutes for each one, we could tell you if they're a terrorist or if they have terrorist ties.
Wow.
That's crazy.
And you talk about cost-effective. How cost-effective could something like this be, Ed?
Well, let me tell you, a polygraph generally throughout the country can range anywhere from $450 to $1,100. Our iDetect test, worst-case scenario, sells for about $160.
Wow.
Per test.
That's right. And here's the really interesting part, I think, is that a polygraph will take about 2 hours to 2.5 hours. And we do those at the investigative agency, and it has its place, believe me. But this iDetect test takes about 30 to 40 minutes, and the results come back within 5 minutes in a printed report.
Ooh. So the next big question is, how does this compare cost-wise for the equipment to, let's say, the polygraph?
If an organization buys 100 tests or more, we give them the equipment.
Ooh.
Really?
Yep.
Man.
Yep.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it really is. And, you know, there's a thing that we do, and we did today, for example. We showed this to the law enforcement folks today, and we did what's called a blind number test or STEM test, it's known as in the polygraph world, where we asked some of the people that were attending today to pick a number between 2 and 9 and to write it down, put it in their pocket, and then to take a 10-minute iDetect test answering true-false questions. And we told them at the end of that test what the number was that they picked. And if we got it wrong, they got the brand-new $100 bill that was sitting next to the computer.
Wow. Oh, nice.
And I still have my $100 bill.
That's incredible. So
that is incredible.
Is this being used anywhere else in the country or anywhere else in the world, I should say?
It's just being introduced now. We're some of the partners with Converis, which is the company that has been licensed by the University of Utah to bring this out to the marketplace. And we actually are some of the first people in the country to hear about this. It's been used in Central and South America for the last 2 years. They didn't have some of the blockades of legislation to put up with there that we have in the United States.
Imagine that.
Can't go figure. So it's been on the ground and in use there. As a matter of fact, the federales in Mexico have a huge problem with corruption and infiltration of cartel members.
Man, no.
And they are gearing up to do 50,000 of these iDetect tests in the next year.
You're not worried that the Mexican drug cartels are going to come wipe out the Lafayette office?
No, senor.
Man, I don't know about this. And it's interesting because, see, I've got the brochure here, John, in front of me, and on the back it lists, you know, the technology, and it lists the companies, including Global Data Fusion here in Noel Center. I think that's terrific.
That's terrific.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're excited. We're very, very excited about this. I think it's a real game changer.
So if somebody in the law enforcement community or anybody wants to do some sort of security testing, how do they get a hold of you? Do they do the Coolidge Boulevard address
there? Yeah, just look up Global Data Fusion online. There's a whole explanation of what iDetect is in one of our tabs. And we'll be happy to go and talk to them and demonstrate the technology.
Cool. Any closing comments before we have to wrap up for Todd Stones?
You know, some of the verticals that we're looking at right now are law enforcement, of course, the airport management folks, because the real issue in airport, you know, the people that work on the ground near the airplanes.
Right.
We can test those and tell you if they're up to no good. Also, the State Department, all the intelligence community folks, even the World Doping Association. We have a test for WADA, and we can tell you if an athlete's been doping.
Have you tested this in Colorado?
No.
I just wonder what the eye scans would do there. Great. Well, thanks for being with us.
I appreciate you
turning us on to this. This is really, really some great technology.
And if you guys would like, even off mic sometimes, I'll give you a demo. And we'll do the blind number test.
No, senor.
I would love to do that.
Well, John, let me know. Let me know when you.
I will do it.
Yeah, come and we'll do that.
Maybe we could do that and video it.
That'd be great. Well, let's do it.
Okay, thank you.
I'll give you $100 if I don't get your number.
Well, as long as you don't ask certain parameters of questions, I'll be glad to do it.
Oh, no.
Absolutely. Right. Thanks, Ed Roy.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.